सब्सक्राइब करिए शॉर्ट एंड डिक्टेशन चैनल को और दबाइए इस बेल आइकन को ताकि आपको मिले लेटेस्ट अपडेट्स।
बी रेडी, 5 सेकेंड्स, स्टार्ट। व्हाट इज नेशनल इंटीग्रेशन? इट इज फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट इमोशनल फीलिंग that binds all individual citizens of this country into one of the great nations. The Indian society is essentially plural with immense diversities of language, culture, local customs and traditions in food, dress, family life and social intercourse and religion. It is this immense diversity that often tempts people to regard India not as a country but as a continent or a miniature world, and makes Indian life a grand variegated mosaic of peerless beauty. This is our great inheritance which few other countries can boast of, and we must do all we can to preserve its salient and beneficial features. But if we have to live and grow as a nation, we must make every citizen of this country realize the basic underlying unity in all this apparent diversity, and we must also strive to eliminate or reduce to the minimum the diverse forces of communalism, regionalism and linguism that tend to disrupt or cloud this unity. National integration may be said to have been achieved when the positive and unifying forces reign supreme in national life and the negative and divisive trends are controlled, if not totally eliminated. This is our goal. It is in this direction that we have been moving throughout our long history. It is in a way a long and endless journey to a great destination. As with liberty, eternal vigilance is the price that we have to pay for national integration as well. The binding together of all citizens in spite of all their diversities into one nation has to be attempted in several directions. It is not a single strand, but a union of several strands which will determine the strength of the national fabric. National integration will therefore have to be positively sought through political, economic and social development, through education, through a decentralized, just and fair administration, and through the generation of confidence and a feeling of security among the minority groups. Each of these aspects deserves some examination. To begin with, national integration is a highly political issue. It is the responsibility of the political system to keep the country together and to provide the leadership for strengthening national integration in all walks of life. The National Congress provided this essential cohesion for the last 90 years. This has been its great service to the people. The relationship between national integration and socio-economic development is also equally close, and in fact as mutually interdependent as the chicken and the egg. National integration, which is needed for the very survival of a nation, is a precondition for development because India must live before India can grow. At the same time, how can feelings of national integration survive for long in a situation of great poverty, where nearly half of the entire population lives below the poverty line and where there are large disparities in income between one social group and another? We must therefore strive our best to abolish at least the government in the organized industry and in the public sector corporations whose incomes and perquisites are well above the general economic level of the population. On the other hand, we have large masses of very poor people living in urban slums, small and marginal farmers and landless agricultural laborers in rural areas who are unemployed or underemployed, whose incomes are very low and who cannot even look forward to 2 square meals a day for most of the year. I know this from my personal experience because I have lived for last 6 years in rural areas and worked as a farmer. How can we hope to have a cohesive society or national integration in a background of such glaring socio-economic inequalities and injustice? We must therefore strive to bring about rapid socio-economic development with social justice. This will create a healthy and hopeful atmosphere in country and reduce the inevitable consequences which extreme disparities generate. Greater and more rapid socio-economic development will follow. It is the golden cycle we must try to establish. The creation of the conditions in which every citizen may be effectively involved in the administrative processes is yet another aspect of national integration. We must endeavor to reorient the administration so that the services are democratized and made more responsive to the needs and aspirations of the common man. It is also necessary to ensure that the common man is assured justice and fair play in all matters which affect his daily life. Even more important are the reforms which will decentralize authority from the center to the states within the constitutional framework and without in any way endangering the fundamental unity of the country. The center and the states are not big and small brothers, but joint partners in national development. Even more important is the devolution of authority and responsibility right down to the present centralized system, where fewer people tend to take the basic decisions for the common man.